Hello guys, this is me Elson Parajuli from techsciencepro.com and you guys are watching Voltego Tutorials channel. In this video I am going to show you how you can port MTK6580 custom ROM for your Android device using a easy ROM porting tool and it is also called auto ROM porting tool. So let's begin. Okay guys, let's begin. First you need to download this required file. I will give the link in the description below. I will zip this script which was developed by Dev Serion. So this is very nice tool for new porter who don't know how to port their ROMs. It will help them to port easily. So today I am going to port Flame 6 custom ROM for MTK650. So here you need to keep in mind that you need a system folder and your boot.img file of your stock ROM for porting. So just copy it to the stock ROM, and you need to copy this Flame 6 to the porting ROM. Now we have two ROM, that is one is stock and another is port, that is Flame 6. So let's learn this tool. Here you can use run as administrator. This is the bath Android kitchen. So here are the developer's name. I recommend you to give credits to them because they have done lots of hard works to develop this tool. Although it is on initial phase and just version 1. So let's start the work. Here it will pass your boot img with your, it will pass the port boot img with your stock kernel. So it will just take some time, just give it permission. It will work on its own. You don't need to copy and paste the bin files, anything else you don't need to, and it will preserve your time because it is auto ROM porting tool, which is very useful and helpful for whom or for those who try testing new ROM on their Android device, who test many ROMs in their Android device. It will save their time. So here press any key and continue. You have to give 8 permissions and it will copy the kernel files to your boot img and it will create new boot img to your porting ROM. So it will work on its own. You don't need to do anything else. It will take some time, but not more than before. It will save your time. So now here we need to put option number 2 to fix some bugs and other things. Keep in mind that you need to know whether you are porting your ASOP based or CM based ROM. Here Flame 6 is lineage OS based, that is CM based ROM. So click option number 3 and by clicking option number 3 you will see that 1 is just fixing If you press one, first you need to press one for the for fixing in which was unable to boot your ROM, and option number two is for fixing all the problem, and finally you have to choose manually. You have to edit your build properties manually, build.prop and updater script. So you need here you will have to edit build prop file with the help of Notepad++. So here you can change the build ID, make your changes yourself, you can change your device name over there. And please don't forget to give credit to the developer, because they have worked hard, they have worked for many hours to develop this tool, and for booting the ROM they have tried hard, and they have compiled this FlameOS for MTK6580 from the source. So give them a credit. Here I am going to change my model to GeonEP5W. Change this according to your needs. So this video gonna be very long, because I think it will be something like 16 to 17 minutes, because I am going to teach you here the every steps that you need to be concerned with the ROM porting and using this auto ROM porting tool for easy ROM porting. So this is the new evolution for us. It's the beginning, but on coming days we will develop it and make it a GUI version, so that it will be far more better than before. Hope developers will work on it, and don't forget to give them credit. Here on this updater script you can change the name, you can change this whatever inside print UI. So here enter your Facebook ID, and here you need to change some mount script according to your Android device. You can do it with some application through the help of some application, that is your EMMC, means that is mount points of your Android device. If your device is different than the other, then please search once on Google and get the solution from there. So you need to change these three mount points. So save it and close it. After closing it, now it's time to compress the ROM, build the ROM. Now we are ready to build the ROM. Just hit enter. Now it's building our ROM. It will take some time. You need to wait until it will go for 100%. Obviously it will take some time because it will make a flashable zip file which can be flashed directly to your Android device using TWRP or Philips or CWM based custom recovery. You need custom recovery to flash this ROM. I recommend you to use TWRP or Philips because these two recoveries are a bit higher and has multi-function which cannot be found on CWM. So guys, after completing this building ROM, this will make you that you will be able to put any type of ROM that is based on LineageOS or CM based or Android open kernel based. You can put any type of ROM, such as you can put ECOP ROM, you can put MM mode ROM, you can put FLIM 6, you can put other BSOP, you can put PAC ROM. So this tool work only on MTK6580, so I recommend you to use only on MTK6580 because while programming the code, it was made for MTK6580. So for other also there will be a auto ROM porting tool, but I don't know about that. I think still developers are working on it and extra developers are still working for that. And on upcoming days, the ROM porting will be very very easy. Even a baby can port a ROM. So think it, guys. And be happy with ROM porting. Give credit to us for this. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. If you like this video, like my videos and share with your friends so that everyone can use this tool and they will motivate. These types of work will motivate the developers to work on it and make it better, because if there will be no any user and no any feedbacks about the bug or whether it's working or not working, then it's not good and not useful too, because the motivation will go down and we will not be able to get any benefits from them because they will stop developing. So our room is completely compressed, and now here you can change the name according to your desire. Here I am going to put Flame 6 OS for MTK 6580. That will be okay. Just click OK, and now just copy to your internal SD card or your SD card. You can copy on your SD card too. So I am going to copy it on my SD card, and after completing it, I will be back soon. Now it's copying. So guys, this was the ROM auto ROM porting tool guide for you who were unable to port ROMs for their Android devices. So guys, this was the tutorial. If you like my videos, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell icon to get notification of latest tech videos from our YouTube channel.